oil-filled shacks. Front. Make sure dog bones are popped back in. Upper control arm back in. Okay. bolt is the rear. Everything's metal too. All our dog bones, drive cups. Shouldn't have a problem with those breaking when they hit a curb at full speed. We'll see. Supposedly there was a rash of bad motors from their supplier when they built these cars. From the factory. Tighten those up and then put the last two screws in for the front differential case. Actually, I did take out front bumper spring on this one because of the LED light wires. We'll have to put those back in. Just two screws. Two shortest screws. And here is the other two longer screws. Again, it's because of having to go through that bumper mount. Slightly longer than all the other ones we've put in. clip never over tightens the bolts. Always have to finish them by hand, which is a good thing when you're working on screws going into plastic or small hardware that can strip out easily. Last is to reattach our shocks. Again, I'm gonna put the shocks in front back into the same holes. Two different positions they can be on the shock tower. The suspension was great, so I'm gonna leave it the same. Sink in the motor. Pops in there nicely. Looks a lot nicer being one piece instead of two pieces too. Front suspension, good. Alright. So, you can see everything's reattached here. Motor's in. Our battery goes. Be charging up our body over there. Charge up a battery and break in the brushed motor after I make sure the transmitter and receiver synced. Nobody wants to watch a brushed motor being broken in, since that's boring. So I will record another video, hopefully with this 490 motor going full speed. See what this Besgar 1 can actually do. I'll do that tomorrow.